Martin Pisun, medicine. For many Indigenous people, medicine is anything that feeds your spirit in a positive way. Whether it's taking part in Indigenous ceremonies, being out on the land, or actual medicines taken from the land and used for healing. In this way, simply living your life in line with traditional practices can be considered medicine itself. On the west coast of Newfoundland, a number of people with Indigenous roots are working hard to bring back their culture and everything attached to it, and this includes the various forms of medicines.
The intention behind the medicine is to help us along on our journey in our daily life. There's different medicines for different purposes. We have sea sage, we have the blueberry. It's a medicine for us as a human. It's the antioxidants in that medicine itself. Then it's the bears who actually eat it, the birds who actually eat it. We share that with them. It's not ours, it's not mine, it's not theirs, it's ours as a unit. And that's why it's meaning all. So that's all of us. So it just blends all together. It's completely everywhere you look if you take the time to look. Before I do any type of harvest of any medicine, I'll smudge first. I'll lay down the tobacco before I take any type of medicines at all. And when I take it, I don't harvest from the root. I don't pull everything up. I'll only take just what I need to, and it's only that way it'll always be able to keep regrowing again. Sea sage is very limited to where it can grow because of the harsh environment that it can sustain. It needs more of not so much of a sandy spot, but enough where there's enough fresh water that can come in from the rains. And it's protected by the wind because most of this, we're around here, our area here, the wind is just that strong. It just wind sweeps everything that touches. Seagrasses will grow a lot better than our sea sage will. I'm going to harvest the more mature portion of the plant because, like I said, it's already on its way of dying and decaying. So, like I said, the leaves will be easier to dry. These are more immature parts of the plant. And it's the base root for these guys here. So he said, we'll try to save these as much as we can. And we don't pull it out and tear it out because if you do it, then that piece, that plant, that part of it is gone forever.
Sea sage, when dried, can be burned in a smudge to prepare people for ceremonies and teachings. Sage is used for releasing what's troubling the mind and removing negative energy. It is also used for cleansing homes and sacred items. For the Mi'kmaq, directions have sacred medicines associated with them, and sage is the sacred medicine of the southern direction.
How can you not enjoy the sound of the ocean on the back? Beautiful sun that's kicking around, and the moisture in the air, it's the freedom to be able to do whatever you want to do.
Mutchie Bennet has studied traditional medicines for many years and is now helping to pass those teachings and wisdom onto other members of the community.
I wish I would have had an earlier knowledge of it because we just didn't. But trying to pick it up now in my 60s is not impossible, but difficult. There's many types of medicines here in our area, birch tree and the spruce for the spruce gum and the var for the blisters, you know, is such an incredible antiseptic and coagulant. Right down to spider webs or cogwebs if someone gets cut, you know. Today I got a couple of close friends, you know, are dropping by and we're going to be having a ceremony or a sweat, you know, and later some moose stew, maybe some dessert. Dean is a really good authority on language for us right now and very able and willing to teach. And Bobby, you know, another good friend who's a wonderful guy, involved in the culture for years, dancing and drumming.
Hello, Gwen.
I'm just scraping the gunnels and getting ready to sand it down. I got to replace a few pieces, but just refinish my canoe. It's long overdue.
Oh, yes.
I got something for you, brother.
Hey. Oh, wow. Oh, man. Nice medicine. Before Dean calls us, do you remember what the Mi'kmaq word for this is?
I... Uk-chil-mu-luk-si.
Hey, right on. Oh, wow, man. Oh, medicine.
Awesome, brother.
Amen. Holy.
Every time that I teach somebody else something and they feed it back to me at a later date, it just gives me cold shivers. It's like they were listening, they're trying, and what I'm doing is worthwhile.
Yeah, it was, I went and picked it up in our special spot near Flat Bay.
Yeah.
The embankment.
Yeah.
And then right in the beginning of Jen's Island is where we picked it up too. So.
Yeah, oh, cool. Good, don't tell nobody.
Definitely not. It's our spot.
Because you brought me some medicine, so I'm going to give you some. And if Dean wants some too, but there's all kinds in the shed there, on the shelf, and in my bags and stuff, or on the table. So help yourself, bring it all out, and take whatever you want.
For Bobby White, the chance to work next to Mutchie and learn about the traditional uses of medicines is also an opportunity to reconnect to his Indigenous ancestry.
I know we got sage, sweet grass, cedar, deerfoot fungus, we got other, like bear root, beaver root, but there's other stuff here that I don't quite know what it is. So I had to ask Mutchie exactly what do I really have, because I'm still learning in the process, so I'm not really sure of certain medicines.
It's all in the hopes of feeding the spirit and creating a larger connection overall to the Indigenous way of life.
Hey, here we go. All right.
Gwyneth.
Gee, you had lots more choices, but that's good. Holy.
Good.
You're going to have a bath later?
Yes.
Nice, man. Nice. Whoa. Deerfoot fungus. That's a good medicine, too. Yeah, you've seen this a lot of times. That's a small sample, but that's that fungus on the dying birch or sometimes witch hazel. I was told that you count up 5 rings or 4 rings from the bottom, and from that up is a good make a tea, and is good for early stage cancer. That's for the old Mi'kmaq people. That was the sacred medicine of the northern direction.
Calvin White is a long-standing elder of Flat Bay. A member of the Order of Canada, White has spent 50 years advocating for Indigenous recognition and rights inside of Newfoundland and Labrador.
When I was a boy, and all the fellers my age, when you got out of school on Friday, you had a little bag you packed on your back, and you took a ball of line and a hook, and you shoved that in your pocket, and your pocket knife, and you went. You were gone for the weekend. You were in the bush. If you knew of some of the older people having some dwelling in there, some camp, you went and you stayed in their camp as long as it was close enough to a river or a pond that had good trout supply. If not, you built yourself a lean-to, and you stayed in that for the weekend. And the thing about it is, you know, if you leave here and you go in the woods for the weekend, you're also getting that physical exercise, you know. You're walking for a full day in, and then you're walking for a full day back, and you're living off the land. Tell me that's not medicine. I'd say 90% of the generation before me were very knowledgeable in medicine. We lived in an isolated community. We had Flat Bay River on the east, and we had Fishel's River on the west, the ocean on the front of us, and 90 miles of wilderness in the back of us. So we never had access to the outside, you know, the hospitals and stuff like that. It was somewhere you went if it was absolutely necessary. Everything else was done in community. We had one elderly lady in particular, Mary Webb, who everybody referred to as the medicine woman. She was a midwife, but she was also the medicine woman. She was the woman who could set people straight. Even though they may have had the knowledge, they never had the knowledge to a degree whereby they could use the medicine in a refined manner whereby you wouldn't bring any harm to yourself. So she was kind of like the protector. If you needed a confirmation on something, you went to her. When you're isolated, you hang on longer to your traditions than when you can push them aside and go to something else. So adjacency sometimes robs people of the importance of some of their culture, adjacency to other items.
I'm going to show you some of the Maui that I was growing.
Oh, this is still curing.
Still fresh.
Wow. A
few days old.
Oh, nice big leaves. Oh, what a lot. Oh, nice, nice, nice.
Nibig.
Nibig.
Leaves.
Leaves.
When I'm studying and learning the language, it gives me a great sense of pride. Historically in my life, I've taken on really big challenges. And I don't know anybody else who was ready to take it on. So I'm really, really, really happy to take that job for my people. Language is my medicine.
What else do I have? Hey. Red willow, Mugwig Spibachin. Mugwig Spibachin.
It's a pretty common saying that let your food be thy medicine. But I promote wild game as the primary protein source. Why? Because it's low fat. The animal is not subjected to confinement over its lifetime. There's no antibiotics. There's no steroids. On top of that is the actual physical activity that's necessary to go out and hunt and to gather fruit and berries. Today's society is hit with a double whammy. The exercise is lost and the quality of food has gone down.
There's a lot of other medicines that are so effective that we don't know or we haven't been practicing it enough, so we're not sure about the right balance or how much, but there's people, you know, still alive that know these things that we can learn from. I really love Sweat Lodge, and it's a healing from the inside out, mentally, physically, emotionally, and spiritually. You know, that's such a huge part of healing for me.
Thanks a lot, man, for the gift. But thanks for sharing your other medicines. And, man, thank you, Dean, for sharing the translations and sharpening us up on a few words.
I make mistakes sometimes. I'm trying.
Hey, we all do. Okay, so since you're here now, I'm going to get you some sandpaper and get a bit of exercise.
Preparing to getting ready for our sweat lodge ceremony. My role here is a fire keeper, which means that I help prepare. Myself, there's a couple of fire keepers, so we all do our share. We prepare the fire, get it ready, get the grandfathers ready, protect the lodge, get all the medicines ready, get the water ready, and get the area ready for our company.
When we refer to the grandfather stones, we're talking about, they're the ancient ones. They're taught to have no eyes, no ears, no mouth, but they see and they hear and they know everything. And they've been around for millions of years. And when they're selected and brought to that sacred fire and heated up in anticipation of a lodge, of a ceremony, they come back to life and they help us. We focus our prayers to them, and the spirit that's within those heated rocks, those grandfathers, they know, they have the knowledge, they've been around waiting to help us. This is what I've been told by the elders. If you doubt your prayer, you quite possibly cancel them. So you reinforce your prayer. You double down, you triple down as often as you need to, and you live a better and a clean life until that next ceremony or that next prayer. It's what's inside of you. It's what you say or what you feel or what you hope or what you need.
For us, it's very important that we use most of the elements from Mother Earth and natural elements instead of using man-made elements. It ties everything together. It gives us that belonging. It keeps us reminded that we're not just made of water. We're not just made of flesh and bone. Same with the animals, same with Mother Earth. Everything's intertwined. One depends on the other. Because without water, we wouldn't be able to survive. Water is everywhere. We're water. We're part of water. We're made of water. when we're born, when we're conceived, we're in a water sac for 9 months. So it's that connection to the water itself. We're all is one unit. Everything is together. We're interdependent on each other.
When I do a sweat, I get peace, I get contentment, I get healing, I get balance. And I share that with whoever's at that ceremony that day. The ceremony is theirs as much. So our prayers or our thoughts or our healing is combined. It's our church. It's our library. It's our museum. It's our place of laughter, of crying, of sharing, of all those things and more. I just don't have the words to express what it really means to me.
So guys, I'm gonna go light our sacred fire. I'm gonna need you guys to turn your cameras off because this is our ceremony is about to begin. And I'd really appreciate if you guys could cameras down and that would be it for today.
I understand, Bob.
Thank you.
All right, thank you. Okay, guys, up there. Thanks, guys.
These ceremonies and the fires associated with them are sacred. And the capturing and sharing of these ceremonies and the actions around them is not allowed. In this way, the medicine of these ceremonies also stays protected and pure.
The ultimate ceremony or the ultimate medicine, I don't think we have yet. But I think it's there. We as human beings, we haven't put it all together to realize or to follow through on what's best for everyone or for the whole. Because most people have been inflicted with that illness of greed or need for yourself and not for others. And I don't want to go any further than that.
Hey,
oh, what
are you, Gadugil? Oh,
Muskajue.
Oh,
right on. You guys are just in time.
Oh, yes. Gewissen, I'm hungry.
Well, you come to the right place.
I think Dean has got a unique way of teaching without making himself appear as the teacher. You know, it's just a friendly conversation. If it's done in a way that's not, well, you're doing this wrong, or you said that wrong, or I want you to do this, it's not in that context at all.
Do you know how you say rabbit?
Obligamuj is the animal. Huh? And then anything that you want to make meat of that animal, you say uwe on the end of it. So it's obligamujwe.
Obligamujwe.
Perfect.
Diamowe.
And diamowe.
Okay, guys, so we'll pull out the table to make a bit more room.
There was a time, you know, that Mi'kmaq people were not allowed to stand around in groups of three or more, or they could be arrested. Those times aren't that long ago. A lot of horrible things that were done to assimilate or to get rid of the Indian problem, you know?
Usually in our culture, we don't say a grace, but sometimes I'll just go like this here. I'll do the same if I see a dead animal along the road, or yeah. Just go Namaltis, you know, or Imsit Nogama. It means so much and it's hard to live up to. It means you're no more or no less than anything that's ever been created, including our food.
Yeah.
So it's a deep appreciation.
What we're really doing is reaching back into the past and trying to reestablish things that, whether it was really, really intentional or not, things were taken away.
Wait a minute.
Eh, wait.
Wait.
Four.
Asamadol.
Asamadol. I think this'll do until I get somewhere to have some real food. No. No, it's good.
Dessert is next.
Good, I'm done.
Mm.
This is really good. I'm glad you guys came in here today and Dean is able to sharpen us up on our language a little bit and give us a little bit of confidence that way.
It's medicine.
Yeah, man. And it's good to share this food because sharing this food is a medicine. And just to talk and, you know, getting together and seeing you guys. And
you know, if we could eat this kind of food all the time, we'd all be much healthier.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Asamadong, I eat too much. But cheers, guys.
Good man. Yeah. Till the next time.
Mm-hmm.
We got a lot to learn. But it's important to me because our overall well-being with the medicines is as important to us as the language or as the food and that connection to the land, that connection to our ancestors, and that connection someday to all those that aren't here yet that are going to follow.
This cultural revival for these three represents the journey towards reclaiming and reviving traditional practices. It is a journey that has taken them each down different paths towards various forms of medicine, but it has shown them all that the journey can be just as valuable as the destination.